ورسوله ويحبه الله ورسوله، يفتح الله على يديه فبات الناس يدوكون ليلتهم أيهم يعطاها. فلما أصبحوا غدوا على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم كلهم يرجو أن يعطاها، فقال: أين علي بن أبي طالب؟ فقيل: هو يشتكي عينيه. فأرسلوا إليه فأتي به فبصق في عينيه ودعا له فبرأ كأن لم يكن به وجع، فأعطاه الراية فقال: انفذ على رسلك حتى تنزل بساحتهم ثم ادعهم إلى الإسلام وأخبرهم بما يجب عليهم من حق الله تعالى فيه، فوالله لأن يهدي الله بك رجلا واحدا خير لك من حمر النعم. The meaning, the hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim. On the day of Khaybar, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam asserted, tomorrow I shall indeed give the flag to a person who loves Allah and His Messenger, and is loved by Allah and His Messenger. Allah will grant victory under His leadership. The people spent the night absorbed in discussing as to whom might the flag be given. In the morning, they came eagerly to Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, each of them hoping to be given the flag. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked, "Where is Ali bin Abi Talib?" They replied, "He is suffering from an eye ailment. He was sent for and brought." Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam then spat in his eyes and prayed for him, whereupon he was cured as if he had no previous pains. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam then gave him the flag and said, "Advance with ease and gentleness, with ease and gentleness, until you arrive in their midst. Then call them to Islam and inform them of their duties to Allah in Islam. By Allah, if He may guide through you a single man to Islam, then it is better for you than the red camels." Now, here, this is on the battle of the Ghazwa of Khaybar, the military expedition of Khaybar. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the day before going to Khaybar, he said, "Tomorrow I will hand over the flag of the army to a man, to one of you, who loves Allah and loves His Messenger." And he's loved by Allah and by His Messenger. So this is what made the Sahaba staying awake the whole night discussing. That this person whom the flag will be giving to, he loves Allah and he loves Messenger. That is normal, because all of them, they love Allah and love His Messenger. But he is loved by Allah and loved by His Messenger. That this person, Allah loves him. So that's why everyone was dreaming and coveting to have the flag. Umar said, "By Allah, I never look forward to having the flag except that day. I was praying that, okay, give it to me, O Allah. Let me be the one So in the morning, everyone was, Umar said, I was trying to raise myself so the Prophet ﷺ sees me. You know? Because Umar radiallahu anhu was tall, by the way, very tall. That's why when during the Hajj, he came to the black stone, and because mashallah strong and tall, and he was just doing like this, and people are moving away. So he said, Umar, take it easy. Don't push the people. So Umar, he was trying to make himself noticeable to the Prophet ﷺ, to draw the attention of the Prophet ﷺ. Are you following? So here, to their surprise, the Prophet ﷺ said, where is Ali? Oh, it's not me. Where is Ali ibn Abi Talib? Where is he? He's the guy, he's the one. So they said, you know, he's sick. He has a problem with his eyes, he cannot see. That's why he sent two of the Sahaba to bring him. And they were leading him, he's almost blind, he could not see. Because of this eye ailment. So the Prophet ﷺ, what he did, he spat. He spat into the eyes of Ali, and they were healed immediately. This is barakah of the Prophet ﷺ. But this is only for the Prophet ﷺ, not for anybody else. Because there are many things which are peculiar, special for the Prophet ﷺ. So you cannot use this hadith, say, see, I can spit into your eyes. You will make me blind. Okay? Okay, because you are not Muhammad Rasulullah. Okay? But the Prophet ﷺ, yes, we have no problem with that. The Sahaba, they were, during the Hajj, when he shaved his hair, they were fighting each other. Everyone wants to take few hairs of the Prophet ﷺ for barakah. You know, one day he slept in the house of one Sahabiya, and he was sleeping on a piece of skin, and he sweated. So the drops of the sweat were there on the skin. So the lady came and started collecting the sweat and putting it in a bottle. The Prophet ﷺ, he woke up, said, what are you doing? He said, oh Prophet of Allah, I want to mix your sweat with my perfume. You want to mix it with my perfume. So the Prophet ﷺ is barakah, no doubt. The people of Medina, they had few hairs of the Prophet ﷺ's hair. They would add, put water on that. And if someone is sick, they will drink and he would be cured. But this is only for the Prophet ﷺ. And the Sahaba understood that. And they did not apply that to Abu Bakr or to Umar or to Uthman or to Ali. No. Are you following? So he said, where is Ali? And they brought Ali and he gave him the flag. But listen to what he told Ali. He said, after he handed over the flag to him, he said, advance, go with ease. Because now the army is moving, they should not make noise. Because if you make noise, what will happen? The enemy will get ready. So you have to go easily. Advance with ease and gentleness. Until you arrive in their midst. And that's what exactly happened. They were taken by surprise. All of a sudden, the army inside the dwellings. How did they enter? So there was no time for them to do anything. except they ran to their castles, fortresses, and then they had negotiations, and finally they signed an agreement that they should stay in Khaybar, looking after the palm trees, and because they say we are experts in agriculture, and each year we'll give you this much or this amount of produce. And the Prophet ﷺ, he accepted that from them. And listen to this. Then you don't fight them, because there is a misconception about jihad. They think jihad is to kill the people. Who said that? No. Jihad, or the fight, it's only a means. You resort.